Catch the Rain is a recent campaign launched by Ministry of Drinking Water Resources. I really support that because the rain happens everywhere, but water storage we depend on, which is very very long distance, either from a city or a more from a city point of view than from a rural point of view. In urban areas today, the water source is a few hundred kilometers away, 50 kilometers away, or more than that. So eventually, we will end up having our water coming from very far if we don't harvest the rain within our city. Now, why is rainwater harvesting and catching the rain very, very important? It is very important, one, to prevent urban flooding. Now, we pave the whole of the city, so unpaving is one of the ways of catching the rain. There are two ways of catching the rain. One is let the nature catch the rain as it is. Another is you put in efforts to harvest the rain and store it for your future use. I think both the strategies should be adopted. The strategy of catching the rain as it happens doesn't happen in the city because everybody paves the, we pave roads, we pave our own homes outside. So we need to really consciously shift to rainwater harvesting through putting paver blocks or the blocks which can let the water slow down and seep in, and therefore the groundwater gets recharged. And other aspect is, here is a situation where we may have rain of say 25 centimeters in a week or something, but we don't have a single drop to drink by March because everything is either flown away, I mean it just went away into the river or sea or channels. And it didn't stop. We need to walk the rainwater, and for that we need to harvest the rainwater with a simple technology where we use sand, gravel, filter it and store it for future use and then reuse it when we don't find water around. Simple logic is, if you are having rain in your premises, why would you ask for water from some other place? So I would only say that it is the right time to launch the campaign, and as Amrit Mission Director, we are also looking at it with a lot of seriousness, and all our officers have also been requested to focus on this. And under Amrit, we have created 2000 parks already, and in these parks we are harvesting water. What else is parks? It's a permeable spaces, green spaces in the city scape where the rainwater will percolate and recharge. So I think we need more parks which serves as a community space, at the same time helps in water to stay where it is. And second thing we would like to say is, please, whenever we build, let us have the contour survey in mind and therefore catch the rainwater in proper channels, rainwater channels, which have disappeared because of unplanned constructions. So I think it's high time we recognize that, you know, we need to catch the rain. There is a third way of catching the rain, just by planting trees, and that should also be done. We need to really plant trees, and trees are the best way, are the best tools or best living beings on earth which can catch the rain in its purity. See, when trees are there, then the water doesn't just hit the ground at one go, it falls on the leaves and drips bit by bit, and that bit by bit dripping leads to a lot of permeable spaces getting saturated because there is no runoff, there is no overcrowding of water molecules in the soil. So I think these are the most important, I think it's the most important thing which we need to do. If you are able to say, gaon ke paani gaon mein, khet ke paani khet mein, ghar ke paani ghar mein, this is the best thing which ever could happen to the country. You know, why should we have centralized energy producers and centralized water producers? Why can't we have decentralized, home-based water and energy situation, which is the way to go? I mean, solar energy comes everywhere. Why do you need electricity from a coal-based or a, you know, polluting way of this thing? If you can shift to solar at home, and then you have also water coming everywhere. So you just put a rooftop harvesting system and harvest water and store it, say in a, say 20-30,000 liters under the ground for your own use. Why not? Because nothing can be better than the rainwater. Of course, you need to let go the first rainwater because there's a lot of molecules which are suspended in urban areas comes wrong with it. But in this continuous rain, you should harvest this water for future use. And people have been doing it for a very long time in their homes through traditional methods. In Gujarat, they are called tankas. It's part of the household. And similarly, in various states, it's called various by various names. But it is important that we need to harvest water. Without water, there cannot be living being. And without water, no city can sustain. It is not the most beautiful infrastructure of the city in terms of roads and railways and other things, but it is the water and the air infrastructure of the city which needs to be maintained well, and therefore we need to catch the rain. Please catch the rain. Please understand, and we all need to understand that, you know, rain is scant, but it is not very scanty for the people. Once we harvest the rain, we really can tide over the water in a very good manner. Another thing which I want to mention is people think it's costly to invest in it. See, because we don't have reliability of water, we invest in a lot of overhead tanks. We invest in a lot of pipelines. A lot of our money goes in laying such huge infrastructure to get water there from very far. I mean, that money doesn't look like as if we are spending for it. You invest in repairs of your connections. You invest in so much. Why can't you have your own water independence? I think we should declare water independence by harvesting water and catching them. Thank you so much.